ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. So today we'll start the common plant toxicities and livestock and the clinical management along with the obscure disease research what we have conducted in our department. So common plant toxicities contain cyanogenic leukocytes, lantana camara toxicity, datura toxicity, nerium toxicity, Ricinus scammonis, and another important plant that's located in Western Ghat areas is the Ficus zahela toxicity. And also another one of the important plant is the Mimosa invasiva toxicities in livestock, and many other livestock toxicities are there due to the plant induced one, and we will also see all of them. Then the coming to the first and important toxicity is cyanogenic glycoside toxicity. That's the cyanogenic glycosides are one of the highest mortality causing thing, especially in case of livestock and the other animals, and especially in the ruminants. And the cyanogenic glycosides are the amygdalin, linamarin, lotustralin, taurine from sorghum, maize, etc. Then the ruminants are most susceptible animals to cyanogenic poisoning, as are more susceptible to the cyanogenic glycosides. And because of the normally mildly acidic alkaline rumen contains, the pH is about 6.5 to 7, and high water content and microfloral enzymes in the rumen hydrolyze the cyanogenic glycosides. And the acute cyanide poisoning is always a dangerous thing for the livestock is concerned, and it is one of the important thing. And sometimes there is regurgitation of rumen contents occurs when the ruminants become recombinant, and bloating occurs. The high blood ammonia levels acquired with increase in the neutral and aromatic amino acids may be a significant cause of the loss of consciousness associated with terminal cyanide poisoning. The mucous membranes are bright red in color because of the oxygen saturates the hemoglobin, whereas it is unable to give or donate the oxygen. That's one of the thing. And the line of treatment is sodium thiosulfate. It's the dose is 50 to 110 milligram per kg IV, and depending upon the severity of the toxicity, as 20% solution is also recommended. So many times you cannot make the 20% solutions. So what you can do is in field conditions is you can administer about 30 grams in 500 ml of the dextrose normal saline or normal saline or dextrose, simple dextrose itself, and I administer it slowly. One of the important thing of the sodium thiosulfate is relatively is less toxic when compared to the other chemicals. As such, the chemicals should not be given, but here we can give it as the 20% solution. And sodium thiosulfate may be given orally to 30 to 60 grams to help the detoxify the cyanide in rumen contents. And sodium nitrite is the one which can also be given in the large animal doses, 5 to 10 milligram per kg as 20% solution. IV, don't use it in horses, and because it causes the hypotension. And another thing is activated charcoal 1 gram per kg as 1:8 slurry has to be administered. Here, whenever you are using the activated charcoal, one, you have to be a little careful, as many times it causes the aspiratory pneumonia. So you should never give it to the owner, because many times the cases end with aspiratory pneumonia. And another chemical is N-acetylcysteine. It provides sulfhydryl groups directly which bind with the acetaminophen metabolites to enhance the elimination, serves as glutathione precursor. The dose is 280 milligram per kg orally or IV in 5% dextrose. The next poisoning, especially in case of the cyanogenic glycoside, is that's the bamboo shoot toxicity in case of cattle. That's why it is very common in case of especially in case of this season, because the cattle get access to the water of this bamboo shoot, and it gets easily come in contact with the animals. Most of the time, the farmers, they throw away the water, and the cattle, after consumption of such water of this bamboo shoot, they get suddenly a complete death. The next plant is Acacia lucifolia, which also contains the pods of Acacia lucifolia do contain lot of cyanogenic glycosides, especially. So one pod is sufficient to kill a sheep which is about 20 to 30 kg in weight. So the pod of this cyanogenic, especially the Acacia lucifolia, is containing a lot of cyanide, and hence many times the farmers, they feed this particular leaves, nothing is going to happen. But whenever the animals, especially sheep and goat, do eat the pods of this particular plant you are seeing here, then they succumb to the death. So you can see that plants do contain the pods, and such pods are eaten by the sheep and they die immediately. So these are all coming under the cyanogenic plant toxicities. And this is one known as the Ipomoea species, or in Kannada it's called as Chappara Ore. So it is also one of the highly toxic plant is concerned. And this plant itself is highly toxic to the sheep and goat and cattle also. Then sometimes by accidental ingestion, the animals are going to cause this particular plant, and they get the toxicities. Yes, here you can see a Malnad Gidda cow has suddenly died after consuming the discarded Ipomoea or Chappara Ore plant. And yes, suddenly they will die because of this Ipomoea species. They contain very high quantity of the cyanide, and hence they are going to die. And the next plant is the Lantana Camara toxicity. And you know that this is a very popular plant, and it causes so many plant poisoning episodes in Karnataka state and all over the India. And Lantana camera, the name is Lantana wild sage, or it's also known as the punch berry, because of the roots of this plant are very dark red in color, and it's one of the 10th most toxic plants in the world. And Lantana occupies the a seizable part of the land area in pastures, forests, so called as the waste lands and orchards. And these plants bearing red, pink, white, here you can see this is a white colored plant, and yellow or intermediate color flowers are present in the different parts of India. Lantana is a very hardy shrub and grows very luxuriously, and it's capable of prospering in adverse soil and weather conditions. It causes hepatotoxicity and photosensitization in grazing livestock, and growth inhibition of the neighboring vegetation, which is rapidly changing the ecological balance. The plant foliage is rough and gives off horse smell, and thus causes the discomfort in case of cattle, and many times it causes the itching and giddiness in the people. And Lantana poisoning in the animals. Recently, there was a poisoning, especially in Rhode, and it was a place known as the Kapatagudda. So, lot of grazing cattle, they consumed this plant and succumbed to the toxicity. So, Bos taurus cattle are more susceptible to the Lantana poisoning than the Bos indicus cattle. But the quantity, if the Bos indicus cattle also ingest the high quantity of Lantana camara plant, then they are also susceptible. The incidence varies from sporadic cases to heavy outbreaks. The estimate of economic losses in terms of the mortality is very high due to the Lantana poisoning are not available in the country. Of course, there is in our country, there are no data available on the plant toxicities itself, the deaths and incidence rates. And poisons with like Lantana act like double this word, because they compete over the other vegetation, which serves as the forage and causes loss of pastures, essentially leaving no grasses or other vegetations. Grazing in Lantana infested pastures results in toxicosis. So it contains four types of the poison. There's the active principles, Lantadine A, B, C, and D, which have a common core structure of 22 hydroxy oleandic acid. And minor metabolites like reduced Lantadine A and reduced Lantadine B are also present in Lantana leaves. Lantadine A has been found to be very toxic to sheep and guinea pigs, and it's considered the major hepatotoxin in the foliage of the toxic taxonomy of the Lantana plant. And mechanism of toxicity, ingestion of Lantana foliage causes hepatotoxicity and secondary photosensitization. And Lantana manifests its toxicity in animals in three phases. One is the gastrointestinal phase, hepatic phase, post-hepatic phase. And ingestion of the by the animal causes digestion of the plant in the rumen, then absorption of the toxin of the rumen and small intestine. Yeah, transportation of the toxin to the liver in portal blood, and metabolism of the toxin in the liver, then secretion of the metabolites in the bile, then metabolites injure the bile canaliculi membranes. So ultimately, cholestasis occurs and retention of the bilirubin, retention of the phylloerythrin, it occurs, and ultimately the jaundice and the photosensitization are going to occur. And rumenostasis is going to occur, which causes the inappetence and absorption of the toxins from the rumen, and further absorption occurs. Interactions of the absorbed toxins with the biomolecules on its hepatocytes, followed by the cascade of biomolecular reactions. The ingestion of Lantana toxins causes paralysis of the gallbladder, the closure of the bile canaliculi, which probably elicits a decrease in bile flow during the poisoning. And cholestasis leads to the regurgitation of the bile, which causes marked increase in the levels of the bilirubin and phylloerythrin. And especially, yeah, both bilirubin and phylloerythrin bind proteins. They undergo phytochemical reactions on exposure to light, which causes photosensitization and skin eruptions. Here in this is a HF animal. Here you can see that eruptions have occurred, especially on the wither region, upper part of where it's exposed to the sunlight. The clinical signs of the lantana poisoning causes severe hepatotoxicity, cholestasis, then photosensitization. The hepatotoxins are present only in the leaves of the lantana plant. The toxic dose is nearly 5 grams of the dry leaf powder per kg body weight. And guinea pig and female rats are the most susceptible laboratory animal models for the lantana toxicity. There is ruminostasis. Animals go off feed often within a couple of the hours and consumption of the lantana forage and become severely constipated. Within 24 to 48 hours, these develop severe jaundice, the conjunctiva of the eyes and mucous membranes of the vagina, and they become ectaric. You can here also you can see that the eruptions, the of especially on the upper part of the body where it is exposed to the sunlight. Yes, you can see here the eyelids become swollen and fissures appear on the muscle, ear tips, and non-hairy parts of the body. Terminal renal failure is going to occur, and animal is going to die. So this is one thing. Activity of the cytosol glutathione transferase is significantly decreased. Then leakage of the lysosomal enzymes from the liver and increase in the plasma bilirubin. Yes, especially in cases of this postmortem, you will get the liver is ochre color and the bladder is greatly distended. The rumen contents are usually dry and undigested. There is impaction of the feces and colon, and adrenals are enlarged. So here you can see this red flowered lantana is highly toxic, whereas the other lantana, especially pink and other things, are not so highly toxic. In treatment, especially there is no specific antidote, stop further exposure of the animals to noxious weed and keep the animal in well shaded areas away from the direct sunlight if photosensitization is developed. And what is the line of the treatment? You have to administer sufficient quantity of the fluids and give purgatives to facilitate the removal of the gastrointestinal contents and replace the ruminal contents with the suspension containing the electrolytes. Chopped. Administer the single dose of the activated charcoal, 3 to 5 grams per kg, to bind the toxin in the rumen and prevent the further absorption. Lantana poisoned cattle can be successfully treated by giving 2.5 kg of powdered activated charcoal in 20 liters of multiple electrolytes, and administer H1 admix and antibiotics to take care of the photosensitization lesions and secondary bacterial infections. And it's one of these, please note down this aversion therapy. It's also known as the conditioning of the animals before they are led for grazing. This is a condition in Western countries or Australia, where they cannot avoid the animal to graze on the pasture. This approach has been investigated for larks for the toxicity also. And the vaccination, antibodies against lantadine A, B, and were detected in sheep and cattle after injection of the conjugates to this compound suitable poisoning. And biodegradation, modification of the ruminal microflora especially can be done, but this is not a common thing in case of India is concerned. Success has been achieved by these techniques, whereas the research group has obtained two organisms, that's Pseudomonas piketty etc. by enrichment of the soil using Lentadine A as sole carbon source for these organisms are the slow degraders of the Lentadine A. That's why there is no specific antidote or any technique that can reduce the Lentana camara toxicity. And the next poisoning is Ricinus communis. All animals are susceptible, including the ruminants, which are less susceptible. Seeds are highly toxic and cake is still more toxic. Has to be fed to the cattle only after boiling to destroy the toxalbumin, that's the ricin. And plant parts like leaves, stem, bark, etc. are not so toxic. And castor seed used for malicious poisoning. You know, malicious means purposeful poisoning. Then, during the latent period between the ingestion of the castor bean, suddenly it will not going to cause the toxicity. During the latent period, the dullness, loss of appetite, etc. are seen, and main clinical signs are especially sometimes it's causing colic, severe colic is going to occur, and main clinical signs are the dullness, incoordination, so there will be sweating, tightening spasms of the muscles, and watery diarrhea are all positive. So the bloody diarrhea and abortion especially occurs after 6 to 8 weeks of pregnant animals and cows, and omission is a characteristic symptom. Diarrhea, not bloody, and cyanotic mucous membrane are also seen. Yeah, this is the beans of this Ricinus communis plant poisoning is concerned, and you can see the castor bee is just like some tick-like structure is present, and many times it causes the severe toxicosis is concerned. The next plant is the Nerium oleander. The toxic principle is neriodorine, wherein which neriodorine, and the root, bark, seed, leaves, and flowers do contain it. And neriodorine or neriocytes, etc. Signs, violent vomition is present. Then the diarrhea, colic, cardiac arrhythmias, and death may occur. So these are the varieties of the Nerium oleander and also the Thevigia peruvina. Here you can see the flowers are very much attractive, and the animals, it may cause severe toxicities. Yeah, this is the seed of this particular Nerium oleander, and this is Thevigia peruvina, and other things are there. Yes, the next toxic plants is Datura species, that's Datura metal, Datura strominium, and so many other things are there. This is the Datura species plants. Many plant species are there, but almost all of them are highly toxic to the animals. And this is a sheep affected with the toxicity of that particular Datura toxicity, in which the animal has become blind. And Datura do contain the atropine, scopolamine, etc., which causes the papillary dilatation. Because of this thing, the animals are succumbed to blindness, because when they are exposed to the sunlight, at that time they become still more blind. Strychnus naxomic, of course, is academically important, whereas clinically not so much cases are observed, because only in case of western ghat this plant is available. In other part this is not so very common. The Strychnus naxomica, the fruits, whenever they are consumed by the animals, they are going to succumb to the death. But when the seeds of this plant, Nectarines somnifera, these are the seeds of the plant, and when these seeds are consumed by the cattle and get digested in the digestive tract, then only the strychnine is released into the stomach and the animals are succumbed to death. Especially these are all the clinical signs, torticollis colis and continuous tonic and chronic seizures are happening in case of the animals that are consumed. And the Strychnus nuxvomica is used in case of these dogs as a malicious poison to kill them. But the barks of this Strychnus nuxvomica are crushed in jaggery and they are offered to the these especially animals for malicious poison. And Ficus zeala is one of the important plant, especially in the western gut area, where in which we have done a lot of research. The rabies-like clinical signs are seen, and the plant is toxic at 2 grams per kg orally. Rabies-like clinical signs are seen, and salivation, excitement, convulsions, posterior paralysis, and finally, it is going to cause the death. And the treatment, what we have found to this Ficus zeala poisoning is diazepam at the dose rate of 0.5 to 1 milligram, low IV with glucose until complete recovery. Along with this thing, we can also use the IV glucose and thiamine hydrochloride and B complex vitamins for faster recovery. Instead of this diazepam, lorazepam, ketamine xylazine combinations, and thiopental and many other CNS depressions can also be used. But the diazepam is one of the most potent drug for this particular toxicity is concerned. And this is the plant, especially you can see that the plant leaves are fresh green or lush green in structure, and the cattle will accidentally consume this particular plant and succumb to the death. And here you can see the clinical signs of Ficus zeala poisoning are salivation like rabies and biting the rope. Both of these clinical signs do have a similarity with that of the rabies. But in this thing, there is, in case of rabies, there will be continuous bellowing. Here, no such continuous bellowing. Same. And Ficus zeala toxicity signs, like many of this, there will be the abducted limbs and excited eyes. And here you can see the animal is biting the inanimate objects, especially the rope, etc. It's going to bite. Whereas lot of salivation is seen. Here you can see the ground is wet. Many such clinical signs are seen. And of course, this is a video. I think you are unable to see it here. This is another plant called the Ficus amplissima. Not so toxic when compared to the Ficus zeala is concerned. And the next plant is the Mimosa invisa. Here you can see that the Mimosa invisa is causing a lot of toxicities in case of the cattle is concerned. It is present in case of the areca nut plantation. So such plant toxicities are very, very common nowadays. This is also Mimosa invisa. And it causes severe perineal edema, especially the Mimosa invisa is going to cause this perineal edema. Here you can see it is causing the perineal edema, especially in case of the cattle are concerned. This plant toxicity is very common in Shikaripur and other areas of our Shivamogga district. And the entire Karnataka state, there is a problem. And here there is no specific pathogen, bacteria could be found. No hemoprotozoan organisms were seen. In step pathology, severe kidney damage with tubular degenerations were noticed. Jelly-like kidney was a characteristic lesion here. A lot of ascitic fluid was accumulated in the abdominal cavity, which might have caused the lesions of perineal edema. The treatment was very unsuccessful with the diuretics because the blood transfusion was also of a little help. Yes. Many of the videos are there. Of course, they are not going to play here. Later, yes. Scrotal edema is also seen in case of male animals. And you can see here that there is edema in the backside of most of the animals. Discrete edema is also seen, especially in case of the mimosa, invisa poisoning is concerned. And here, irrespective of this cattle, buffalo, etc., sheep and goat, animals are going to succumb to die. Here you can see the discrete edema of that particular animal seen. The kidneys, there is here, in case of mimosa invisa poisoning, it is containing a toxin known as mimosin, which is going to cause the toxicity, and it causes the multiple organ failure. So here the lesions will be found in kidney, liver, heart. Lot of hemorrhages are seen in the heart, etc., and hence you can also see the hemorrhages are present in the various organ, and because of this endothelial cell damage, the animals are going to have the ascites. So after here, you can ask the treatment. There are no specific antidotes for the particular mimosa invasive poisoning, but to some extent, in the initial stages, it responds to the sodium thiosulfate as a 20% solution, very similar to that of the cyanide poisoning. But how this is not containing the cyanide, but the animals are recovering to this to some extent in the initial stages, whereas in the later stages, the animals are not going to recover. Other causes of the perineal edema, and there is another one important plant known as the Embolia xerium cottam. Embolia xerium cottam is one of the plant that's also going to cause the toxicity, especially in case of the animals. But this is the plant known as Embolia xerium cottam. In Kannada, it's called as the Vayu Vilanga. So this plant is also going to cause severe toxicity, very similar to that of the Mimosa invasa, and this is having the toxic principle known as embelin. Embolia xerium cottam, this plant is known as the Embolia xerium cottam, and it is having the toxic principle embelin. This is a very lush green plant located throughout the Western Ghat, and especially the Malnad Gidda and buffaloes are going to eat this particular plant and succumb to death. The dung of the particular plant is having lot of as very hard tissues, and sometimes it is such a hard that you cannot break it down. And this, because of the hard feces, is because many times the animals never drink the water for 10 to 15 days. Hence, there is severe perineal edema. Yeah, next. Next is the toxicity caused by the Mimosa pudica. Of course, it's not so toxic when compared to the Mimosa invasa is concerned. Cows are ingesting fresh chopped. We have conducted some experiment, especially in case of Mimosa pudica is concerned, and hence it is very highly toxic plant. The Mimosa invasa is highly toxic plant compared to the Mimosa pudica is concerned. Other plants, so many other plants are there. Abrus fractorius, the toxicity is very, very rare, but for the academic purpose, you can remember that these plants are also highly toxic. And orally, seeds are not much toxic, as outer coat is not, seeds are not so much toxic as the outer coat is too hard to distinguish. Whereas the pulp is highly toxic. 50 gram arrested seed death within 18 hours in case of cattle. Whereas this is a malicious poison used in case of the human beings. The seeds of the plants are widely used for marketing, making necklace and other articles of the jewelry use. White seeds are more toxic than the red or brown seeds. Abrin has the property of agglutinating RBCs. Even the whole seeds may cause, chewing the seeds may cause death in case of poultry. You can see the beautiful plants here, especially the Abrus rectorius. Clinical signs: severe gastroenteritis. Half seed in case of man, signs after 12 hours. The latent period is also very, very high. And 20 times, so it causes, in case of human, it causes incoordination, paralysis, salivation, general hemorrhages, and and death within 2 to 4 days of clinical signs. And treatment: subcutaneous injection of anti-abrin serum vaccination against the abrin. Since the death is very, very fast, it's very difficult to treat this thing. Yeah. This is another plant known as Ipomoea illustris, and we have induced this particular plant toxicity in case of an animal which is going to cause the toxicity. Ipomoea illustris. This is the Ipomoea illustris. And that's about the plant toxicity is concerned. And now we can go to the obscure diseases. We'll see what are the obscure diseases, especially whenever you are working in the field conditions, you may encounter many such diseases. These are all the obscure diseases, means whose etiology is not known but is attributed to the plant or the mycotoxicosis. So we here we can see this perennial edema, brisket edema, one leg edema. Sometimes there is severe omission or regurgitation will also be present in the cattle. Many times Downers or standing cow syndromes are there, and another thing is amaurosis or some of the nervous disorders, teeth gangrene, salivary syndrome, ataxia, neurosis with or without seizures, circling and head butting will be seen, and hind leg asthenia, abortions, etc. are also seen, and dermatosis of entire body or extremities is seen. Atrophy of the scapular muscles is also seen. And we already seen that Spica's cella, it was once upon a time an obscure disease. But now we have found that particular, especially, it is going to cause a disease known as the Minchukaila in case of Kannada. And these are all the clinical sciences what we have found. And please go through the video here. Yeah, especially in case of Pica's cella toxicity, cycling movements are seen. You can see here, paddling movements are seen in case of the animals. Once upon a time, this was an obscure disease, and to this animal, we have fed the plant Ficus zehla. And here you can see that animal is having the behavior of eating or biting inanimate objects, which is going to confuse us with that of the rabies. Of course, we have seen the Mycosaenisa poisoning. All these were obscure diseases once upon a time. Here, this is a very typical case of Embolia xerium cotton toxicity. Embolia xerium cotton toxicity. And here you can see that perennial edema is going to occur, especially in case of the cattle and buffaloes which have consumed the plant Embolia xerium cotton. So this disease was always used to be caused as perennial edema, and now we have confirmed that this toxicity is attributed to the Mycosaenisa as well as the Embolia xerium plant toxicity. Here you can see that most of the animals affected are belonging to the local or desi animals. Especially these animals are Malnad Gidda animals, and here you can see that the animal is having severe perennial edema, especially the vulval edema, etc. And most of these animals are belonging to the very, very poor persons. Here you can notice that the perennial edema to the very great extent, the vulva has totally swollen, and here you can also see there is edema everywhere in the body. So this animal, none of these animals could not make them to get what you call as recovered. Yeah, all this we have seen sheep death, especially, and mycotoxicosis is already explained to you. So it's a common practice of to feed the sorghum still sorghum fodder, etc. So whenever we have feed it to the extent of 2 to 3 months, then we'll get the toxicities. The milking buffaloes, so the mycotoxicosis is a very common poisoning. I think in the earlier seminar also I have told about these things. This mycotoxicosis occurs whenever the animals do consume the fungal infected fodder after 2 or 3 months earlier, or otherwise they are not going to cause any such toxicities. And excess salivation, hind limb paraplegia, dyspnea, vomiting of the hind leg, etc. And the toxicity of groundnut hay affected with the fungi. Here you can see that the stale groundnut hay is fed to the Amrit Mahal animals, especially the Shirad Taluk of Tumkur district, and most of the animals got affected with the fungal or mycotoxicosis. Concerned. And groundnut hay affected with the fungal infected groundnut hay. You can see many such things are there. And many of the fodders we neglect, especially the farmers also do neglect, that nothing is going to happen to the animals, but it is going to cause lot of what you call as the non-specific diseases which are going to affect the productivity and reproductivity of the cat in terms of decreased milk yield and repeat breeding, and some of the hidden diseases which we cannot diagnose very properly. Here you can see the hemorrhages in the conductive of the bullock affected with the stale groundnut hay poisoning. Hemorrhages in conductive of the bullock, you can see here. hemorrhages in the tongue of a bullock, you can see in this particular photograph is concerned, and bleeding from the rectum of a bullock is also seen here. Then the hemorrhages in rectal mucous membrane of a bullock is also seen, and hemorrhages in the scrotum of the bull is also particularly seen. Then the buffalo calf affected with the toxicity after consuming the meadow grass fodder was containing the fungi belonging to the Penicillium species. So hundreds of such fungi are there, and many are secreting the mycotoxins, and many are causing toxicity in case of cattle. Toxicity of paddy straw affected with fungi rhizopus. The clinical signs are like this. There is tenesmus, and also so many times the animals are not going to consume anything. And here there is a high incidence of fractures in bullocks of the Hubli area, and outbreak of the fractures what we can say here. And we have examined many such animals and found that there is a fracture in the humerus. That's the humerus bone, which is also called as the weight gaining bones, especially in case of the bullocks. Yes, you can see such type of the oblique fractures are seen in case of the animals. And this is fungal infected sorghum fodder which was fed to the animals. You can see that the black sorghum fodder which is infected with the fungi, which is going to be consumed by the animals and going to cause the porosity of the bones, and the animals were very much susceptible to the fractures. The fodder affected with fungi. And the farmers are asking us the question that why the animals, especially the buffaloes, are not so succumbing to the fracture. It's very simple that these animals are not used for the plowing purpose. Yeah, here in between this cotton seed, cotton crop, we have seen that several maize, and this has been fed to the animals. And coming to the conclusion that mycotoxicosis is a common problem in case of livestock, and many more diseases were suspected to caused by the mycotoxicosis, and buffaloes are also susceptible to the mycotoxicosis compared to the cattle, and many fungi are yet to be identified and isolated, and there is necessary to establish the toxicity in case of laboratory animals. And potassium acetate therapy was proved to be better, but one has to use this potassium acetate with a lot of care, because whenever there is a Downer's cow syndrome also, the potassium acetate is available as a 500 gram chemical. You can use it as a 10 milligram per kg slow IV, but it has to be administered in case of very slowly, or otherwise many times the animals are going to succumb to death with fast administration of the potassium acetate. Or otherwise it can also be administered as orally. Potassium acetate can and gives good result in the field conditions. And of course the mycotoxicosis is a very, very less reported case in case of India is concerned. Of course we cannot find any. Many dermatological disorders are also seen in case of the buffaloes, the cause of which is not in the back. And dermatological disorders this is another obscure disease that's called as the commercial cattle feed induced dermatitis. And dermatological disorders, many type of the skin disorders are common in case of the large animals, and lesions have been identified on the hump, either neck, ear, tail, face, and medial to thigh and udder in between the horns, between dew claws, etc. Although the etiology is not yet established, however, the animals respond to environmental treatment, but reoccurrence is a common feature. Such cases will respond to the mixture of sodium sulfate to the extent of 30 grams, zinc sulfate 20 grams, copper sulfate 20 grams, ferrous sulfate 20 grams, and magnesium sulfate 1 kg, dose is 20 milligram, 20 grams twice a day for 15 days, and many of the times the animals are going to recover. And this is another case, that's gangrenous mammalitis in case of the buffaloes. And these are all the different stages. Initially, there will be a swelling, then it causes a black necrotic ring is formed here, then the teeth falls off. And even though the animal recover, here you can see that strictures are formed, especially in the teeth region. So because of this particular disease, many farmers are facing the economic loss in terms of the loss of milk. And this disease is a herpes virus induced disease, especially in case of buffaloes. For primary parous buffaloes are more susceptible when compared to the multi-parous buffaloes. And that may be due to the hormonal effect. And many times, it's just like a virus infection, it is going to respond to many drugs in the early stage. There is anti-herpes virus, bovine herpes virus can be treated with some of the antiviral drugs. Yes. Whenever we have used certain antiviral drugs, the animals have increased. This is a very common problem in case of the buffaloes. Suspected etiology is herpes virus, but not demonstrated. Milk will be normal, no bacteria seen. The response to therapy depends upon the stage of the disease. In the early stage, it's going to respond to a regular antihistamine and analgesic injection therapy. The therapy with a 4-6 teeth spray, 100 microgram, metered inhaler, Astaline, and Cipla, metered inhaler may cure the disease. There are beta 2 adrenergic receptors in the teeth, and it is going to reduce the disease severity. Three cases may respond to some of the ethnoveterinary practice, like the topical paste of the plant preparation containing the bark of the Croton oblongifolius and tuber of the Curcuma longa. Because this Curcuma longa or Rhodiola is also having the antiviral properties. The therapy with lithium antimethylamylate, it's also known as antimethylamylate, is somehow it's good, and I have written some of the papers. Promising result will be there if the injection of terbutaline, etc., are given to the base of within 2 cm apart. And apart from this one, dexamethasone and gentamicin, they can be given. Never give the injection of diclofenac more than teeth based on the animal, and never allow the animals to be suckled by the calf. Autoimmune therapy is also promising result it has given, and 15 days are required for complete recovery. And homeopathic and Ayurvedic drugs, there is a what you call as a conflict is there. Kneeling the syndrome, you can see here that it's going to kneeling syndrome in which the weight rests on the knees. This condition was observed in animals of this Mudhol and Jamkandi area. It's a peculiar disease of the buffaloes of northern part of the Karnataka during the visit. The animal could get up with difficulty and used to stand on its knees with elevated hand. But notified during the late rainy and early winter season, the dystrophy of the skeletal puzzle is a characteristic clinical sign. abdominal type of the respiration will be noticed. The scapular spines were prominent and the suprascapular muscles were thin. On tail and ear gangrene, you can see that many animals here the tail and ear gangrene was seen. And since it's not a deadly disorder, nobody is bothered. But it's one of the condition caused by some of the mycotoxins which are having ergot-like alkaloids. Yeah, ear necrosis. Should I have a kit to treat the common toxicities like atropine sulfate, diazepam, dexamethasone, sodium thiosulfate, activated charcoal, potassium acetate, sodium citrate, sodium acid phosphate? All these things are required for blood transfusion. Like sodium citrate, it's available as the 500 gram bottle is useful for blood transfusion, and sodium acid phosphate is also required for the phosphorus supplementation. Thiamine hydrochloride and approximate cost is about 3,500 rupees per year to purchase everything. Where these are available? Vasa Scientific Company, Sri Kanika Scientific, and especially in Bangalore and Sudha Traders, you can get especially this particular thing. Yeah. With this, we are going to end this particular technical session is concerned. And thank you very much for staying with us for such a long time.